A couple weeks ago, I released the Final Cut Pro Essentials Toolkit. As a bonus to the collection of Final Cut Pro tools, I included a couple shortcuts for building a folder structure to organize your media. Running one of these shortcuts creates a project folder for you with a structure of folders inside. There's a shortcut to the video project folder I use for my projects, and a custom one you can customize to better fit your needs. Today, I'm going to show you how I built these shortcuts and how you can tailor the custom one to suit your needs. Now, if you bought the plugin and just want to modify the folders in the custom shortcut, you can skip ahead to here. But I strongly recommend watching the entire video. This way, you'll have a good understanding of how the shortcut is built and are less likely to run into any issues. Also, for this demo, I'm going to build a folder structure for making a video, but this can be used for any project that requires organized media, files, or documents and folders. Let's get started. Open the Shortcuts app on your Mac and click the plus button near the top to make a new shortcut. Give it a name, and if you want to, change the color of your icon and what's inside. This is for a video project, so I'll search for movie and add this film strip icon. For the first action, we want to create a folder. The quickest way to find actions is by using the search bar. Search for create folder and double click this action to add it to your shortcut. Now, you have a couple options here. If you want to make this folder structure in the same location every time, just click on the shortcuts button and select the destination for your folders. If this is the route you want to go, you can go ahead and skip to this part here. For this example, I want to be able to select the location for this folder each time. To do this, right-click on the destination button and select shortcut input. This adds a new action at the top. Click on the first variable and make sure only folders is selected. Click where it says nowhere and on the right-hand side, select use this quick action and select both Finder and Services menu. This just gives you a few more options as to where you can run the shortcut from. Down in the Create a Folder action, right-click on Shortcut Input and select Ask Each Time. Click on Folder and enter the prompt you want to use. This is asking for the storage location of your folders, so let's enter Select Storage Location. Right-click on Path and once again, select Ask Each Time. This is a prompt to name your folder, so let's use Project Name. Now, when you run the shortcut, you'll first be asked to enter your project name and then select a storage location for it. To add subfolders inside this folder, we'll use Create Folder Actions again. Go back to your Actions library, grab the Create Folder action, and drag and drop it into your Actions list. Right-click on Shortcuts and select Select Variable. This is where we can select where the subfolder goes. In this case, we want our subfolders inside our top-level folder, which is this one right here. So clicking this Create a Folder button under our main folder places our new folder inside this top level folder. Click on the path box and type in a name for this folder. Let's call it Video. I also like to add a number at the start of the folder names just to keep them in the order I like. Let's create another folder, select Variable, and also place this one inside our main folder. We'll make this one for Audio. Add as many folders as you need here. Placing more folders inside these subfolders is just as easy. For example, if you want to add an A-roll and B-roll folders inside your video folder, you add another Create Folder action, select Variable, and this time click the Create a Folder button under your video folder. Let's call this one A-roll. Repeat these steps, make another folder, and call it B-roll. Another thing you may have noticed here is some actions are connected by lines and some are not. Even though action placement doesn't matter here, if an action directly corresponds with an action above it, it's connected with a line. So, because our first three folders are directly connected to our main folder, all three are connected with lines. The next two aren't directly connected to this one, so no connection lines. If we were to drag these up and place them directly under our video folders, then they would be connected. This is strictly to help you organize your workflow. There's a few ways you can run this shortcut. Obviously, you can run this from your Shortcuts app. Just open it up, hover over the shortcut you want to run, and click the play button in the top right corner. But there are faster and easier ways to run this. One way is you can run the shortcut from the Services menu in the menu bar. To run it, select Finder, Services, and your shortcut. But my favorite way, since I use the shortcut all the time, is to run the shortcut right from your dock. Go back into your Shortcuts app, select the shortcut you want, right-click on it, and add it to your dock. Next time you need to run it, bring up your dock and click on the shortcut to run it. Follow your prompt, and in just a few clicks, you have your own custom folder structure. Now that we have a good understanding of the shortcut, let's open up and modify the custom folder template from the Final Cut Pro Essentials toolkit. In this template, we have 6 folders inside our main folder, with 5 subfolders inside each folder. Before we modify this, let's first make a copy of the shortcut. Right-click on the shortcut and select Duplicate. Double-click this copy to open it up. Up in the top left corner, give the shortcut a name and select an icon for it. The first action in this workflow is the prompt about storage location and the name of the main folder. Leave these as they are. Under this, we have an action to make folder 1. Left-click on the name of this folder and replace it with your own. Now, the next 5 subfolders are inside this main folder. To rename any of these, just left-click on the text, select the text, and replace it with your own. To delete any unnecessary folders, hover your mouse cursor over the action and click the X on the right-hand side to delete it. Go through the shortcut and rename and delete the remaining folders to suit your needs. If you delete one of the higher level folders, any subfolders within that folder will have an error in the variable, highlighted in red text. To prevent any errors when you run the shortcut, delete these actions as well. If you need to add an extra folder or subfolders, just follow the steps from earlier on in this video. When you run this custom shortcut, a folder structure is created for your next project with folders inside that specifically suit your needs. Now, if you don't want to manually go through all the steps involved in making these shortcuts, the shortcut I use and the custom shortcut we just modified is available in the Final Cut Pro Essentials toolkit. You also get many other super useful Final Cut Pro tools, including movable horizon guides, to-do titles, and more. Check out this video right here to learn more. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.